Morning, students. So we are commencing unit 3. Some of the concepts that what we have seen in unit 1 and 2 can be transformed here to understand some more on web services. This chapter completely focuses on components of web service. What are all mandatory to create a web service? What is its platform? What is its architecture? And what are the ways to create the web service? What are all the technology support provided for writing web services? So all those things that we are going to discuss here in detail, along with the web service interfaces too, right? Because service, yeah, that means based on yesterday's MCQs, that we are going to see both SCDL as well as WSDL in this chapter. Okay, so along with that, messaging protocols and discovery mechanisms, that's also we are going to look out. So to commencing with that, these MCQs will test your fundas as well as will educate you something. Yes, the first one, a DAS role is a virtual machine instance running the Microsoft IIS web server, like Apache. This is the product from Microsoft that can accept and respond to HTTP or HTTPS requests. So that's what the word revealed, Microsoft IIS web server, right? So ultimately its role will be on web only, right? So that's what the answer also, right? So the reason to give this MCQ is you must know the different types of flavors in different vendors. That's the reason why these types of MCQs has been given. Okay. For example, if we go for Apache, we are having a set of servers. Even if you go for IBM, we have some set of servers are available. Okay, so likewise. So even in Microsoft, we have these type of web servers are available. So within our JDK for Java, we are having Java web server, JWS. Right? You can access it, you can access that even through command prompt. So that has been designed in that way. So moving with that, since it is related to web service, the question has been framed in this way. Which of the following element allows you to create and manage virtual machines that serve either in a web role or under worker role, both the roles? Web role and the worker role. Web role is nothing but the server. Worker role is nothing but the client. Right? So based upon the terminology of web services, we will be using these terms, nothing more than that. Okay. So instead of using the term client server technology as a separate infrastructure, since we are giving infrastructure also as a service in the environment, we are using this term, web role and worker role. So among that, which one that we are ready to comment on? So either I'm going to use as a compute service or application service or storage service. Which one I'll use that? Okay, so compute service means it is used for calculations and processing. Application service means it is nothing but the interface or presentation layer of a corresponding software. Storage represents the place where we will, that could be the term of secondary storage device, as well as for primary storage device for my increasing the speedness of compute engine. Okay. So ultimately, the role of server or client that can be decided based upon compute service only. Right? Compute service. See, these MCQs are scrapped from Microsoft Azure Web Services, the certification exam for Microsoft Azure Web Services. Third one, which of the following element is a non-relational storage system for large-scale storage, right? So the question itself will talk more about storage. So they are talking about data store, data lake, or database, or DBMS. So ultimately, among these three components, which one can be chosen? Ultimately, it is going to be the storage only, right? Storage only. Fourth one, Azure storage plays the same role in Azure that same place in Amazon Web Services. They are asking the equivalent web service for Azure storage. Anyone, I think people are preparing in the stage of campus interviews. It could be like a GK question. Could you able to answer anyone of you? Through chat box, you could able to give answer. The corresponding web services of Amazon that is relevant to my Azure storage in Microsoft. What is the corresponding Amazon web service? Any answers in the chat box? I found most of the students are doing certification courses and being displayed in LinkedIn. I found most of the students have completed services based on cloud computing and other certifications also. What is the corresponding storage web service in Amazon? That is the question. Any answers? Chat box is empty. So the purpose of doing certification is only to get certificates, not to earn the knowledge, right? So ultimately it represents S3, okay? So S3 is the corresponding storage web service that has been synced with my Azure storage. And last, so what is the management service for Azure? That's the question, okay? Management service for Azure. So if I want to include management service, it is a default service that will be available in all the virtual environment. Okay. So if I'm going to hire a complete cluster from Azure, in that case, by default, this service will be incorporated. If I'm going to hire more than one or rent more than one storage environment, I have the option to hire this, right? It could be like already Amazon platform or Azure platform will track my rental services. But apart from that, I could hire or by default, they will provide a service to manage the rented cluster, to manage the hired cluster. Okay, suppose I have hired some 15 machines. So to manage that 15 machines, they will issue this service. So that's nothing but my config service. So that will help me to completely manage the service request and response happening between my hired environment with the vendor. Okay, either it may be Azure or Amazon, whatever may be. For Azure, the corresponding service is config. Okay, so that's the point that I want to stretch with. See, I suggest the students, you try to be specialized in any one of these three services, okay? Because these three services, by using these three services only, people are being deploying their environment in the clients, okay? If you go for any MNCs or if you go for startups, among these three services, you should be very clear in any one of these services. Either you are very good in the services, web services of Google or web services of Microsoft or web services of Amazon. Either any one of the services you have to choose and travel forward. You should be specialized in these things. Again, subspecialization, you should be very clear in this, any one of these three things. either you are going to specialize in compute service or application service or storage service. Okay, so people who are having strong computer architecture knowledge can choose for compute service or storage service. People who are very good in development and programming environment, you can choose for application service. So likewise, you can have the sub-specializations also. So likewise, make yourself be comfortable in any one of these services, and you can go for certification. Right? You can have a general certification. Next, you can go for a specialized certification. They will give us associate. Okay, so that's the recommendation from my side. Have eye on that. Instead of doing general certifications, you can go for specialized certifications. That will increase your employment rate as well as your package. That's the thing. Okay. So in this chapter, we are going to see only three things. We are going to see the overview of those three things, as well as the different case studies, different programs, how we have seen programs in our first chapter. Likewise, we are going to execute and see some programs based upon our these three components. What are all the three components that we are going to focus in this chapter? First one is SOAP. Second one is WSDL. Third one is UDDA. So these three components are enough for me to manage the web services. Okay. Manage the web service means starting from creation, development, launching, initializing in the SOA environment, and after initialization, syncing with the interfaces, how we are managing it entirely on the framework. So we are going to see it in a with a deeper understanding, right? First we will see what would be the implication of these things, right? why only these three components will play a vital role when we are going to talk about our web service. So that's the major concern here, right? Once you understand these three components, you can start constructing your SOA framework, right? Okay, SOAP, Simple Object Access Protocol. It has been decided and taken forward, right? I think this protocol was introduced during 2000-2001, during that period. The period where web technology is evolving, right, during the time. Even web services are being not identified properly, but with some other names, web servers are providing services on those time, right? So on those time, this SOAP has been emerged, as well as the time .NET framework also emerged. We people are learning C# during 2001-2002, during that period. In that period only, the role of SOAP has been identified through us, because while introducing C#, we don't have more functionalities to work with it. Whatever we want to do, we will derive it from VB and we will use. So what we will do, you know, we will write a C# program. Some functionalities will not be available there, but in VB.NET, we will have that functionality. So what we will do, we will get the code of VB.NET. I will compile using the VBC, right? This is the cross compiler for my environment. On compilation, it will generate me a class file, like our Java. So this class file can be combined with my execution environment. When C# is going to run, I don't use the term dot class, just like DLL file, right? We generate a DLL file. This DLL file will be linked with my environment. Dynamic link library. During execution, it will call. Okay. So how we are executing our Java program? The same way only we have to execute my C# program. File name dot CS. This is the syntax of the corresponding environment. File name dot CS. So what I will do means, I will compile the program using CSC, C# compiler, CSC file name dot CS. So next what I will do, I will interpret the program using CS exe name, right? In Java, it will give you class file on compilation. In C sharp, on compilation, it will give you exe file. Okay, so that exe file will be executed using the name itself, right? I may use CS that exe name. Otherwise, I will simply type exe name and I will enter. While I'm going to execute that, the compiled DLL from Visual Basic will be Visual Basic .NET will be called and will be integrated. It will give me the output. So the functionality from VB.NET could be interoperable with my functionality in C sharp. This is within the environment. That means within the .NET framework, right? Later stages, when applications are going to emerge in most of the environments, in that case, I could able to communicate between a Java package from the package in C sharp, right? So the heterogeneous communications are ready to happen. In that case only, these types of protocols are ready to emerge. Among that, the first category is our SOAP, right? XML have given us a major role here, okay? Lightweight protocols, if I need to design, I have to use SOAP. Even we have the functionalities exist nowadays that you could able to create your own protocols, right? So SOAP is a XML based protocol. As well as, and here you have to note over a point, applications exchange information over HTTP. What does it mean? The role of this protocol will work on our network, the OSI layer, right? Remember that. Will work on our, especially HTTP represents that. It will
see whether it is audible or not. Put it in the chat box. Today we are going to discuss about the web services concepts. What is web services? Do you have any idea? Right, example for that electronic device in the sense laptop, mobile, whatever it may be. Is it clear, right? And what are the device we have it? What are the device it's having the capable for sending and receiving the message? That and all we call it as a electronic device here. Okay, simply we say for that node. So the definition for the web service, it is used to communicate one electronic device to another electronic device over the internet. Is it clear, right? Next, we go to that.
Sir, party, sir. It's over.
Yes, sir.
My voice is audible. Oh. Huh?
Okay, yes, sir.
Okay, sorry. I think there is a technical glitch. I think the place that where we are discussing is when heterogeneous applications want to communicate, mandatorily I have to use this SOAP. So they are ready to give the support in the application layer itself. That is a major concern here, right? So even you can designate a protocol, even you can design your own protocol to communicate between your frameworks. You have the RFCs to design for our XML based protocols, right? And you can construct when you are going to create your own SOA framework for the environment, you can construct or devise your corresponding SOAP. You can configure your own SOAP, right? So that much privileges you have when you are going to use with your XML, right? So that's the idea. Applications exchange information over HTTP. The term represents that the protocol is readily and freely available to communicate between applications. Especially it will operate well in the application layer of our network, right? So the SOAP expansion has been given. It's a communication protocol, as well as it is used for sending messages. We can communicate via internet. What is the term via internet, right? It is nothing but the terminology represents that via the data layer, I could able to communicate even through SOAP, right? And as well as, since it is designed using XML, it is platform independent as well as language independent. The main reason is XML only. See, the an important thing, the last 2 points are very, very important. SOAP allows you to get around firewalls, right? SOAP allows you to get around firewalls. What does it mean? So when you are going to implement new services, your antivirus software will not allow you to activate that service. You have to turn off your firewall. You have to turn off your antivirus software. Make these services to be allowed. That's what the term, you to get around firewalls. So that is the negligible case when we are going to implement through SOAP for the communication. The main thing is here. W3 standard, World Wide Web Consortium have recognized SOAP as a standard. Okay. See, the common thing between the three contents that what I have shown today, SOAP, WSDL, UDDI, these are all being framed as a standard when I am ready to create a web service, right? If you are going to create a web service, that will be, that need to exhibit these or that need to obey the protocols of these corresponding three entities. Okay, so that's the thing behind all these three components. WSDL. So what does this WSDL? It is a XML actually. WSDL is entirely written in XML, like our SOAP. Okay, it is entirely written in XML. It's a language again. What is the purpose of this? It will give two things. First one is, it will tell what this web service will do. Okay. Second thing, it will convey how to access the web service. These two things will be mentioned by this WSDL, even in the program itself, right? A very simple thing. If you are going to write a program for addition of two numbers, you are writing a Java web service. Assume that you have created in Eclipse or in NetBeans, whatever maybe. You have the provision to create web service. Once you create the web service, it will create web service framework of the corresponding architecture will create request and response messages through this. Okay. The request message will have the variable. The response message will have the value. That's all. That means the request message will have A and B that is having some value, right? 3 and 5. The response message will have the result. That's all. Okay. So, how to access that variable through that function name or the web service name. So that can be accessible via that. So they will mention it very clearly. We'll see by through some programs also, right? This is the functionality of WSDL, right? This is common for all the languages. That's the major criteria. See, the request message and response messages generated through this WSDL is common for even if you write in C sharp or if you write in Java or any programming languages that have the support of server side scripting, it is ready to generate the same message only, right? That makes that platform neutrality, platform independency. These when application A want to communicate with application B, these general messages will help us. That's all. Right? I'll show you through the diagrams. I could able to convey that. Again, you could able to see that an important term they have mentioned. WSDL is also used to locate web services. Right? It is a locate web services. Right? It's nothing like you have the index. Right? You could able to access it. Even compared to WSDL, when you are going for the next topic, that will give you the mechanism very clearly on location of web services. Again, see, again, it's a W3 standard. That's the major thing that you have to remember. It's a standard, right? Standard. Standard represents that it could be the benchmark for this. Okay. As well as if you are going to create anything new, that need to obey this standard. If you have anything extensible on this, right, you could able to see here. SOA, SOAP is simple and extensible. If you are going to extend any functionality that is acceptable, over that it need to follow the basic standard. That's the idea here. Okay. And the third component, UDDA. Okay. Universal Description, Discovery and Integration. This is the main person that will exhibit your component to outside world. Right. I have created a web service. That's all. How it will be known to the outside world? How others will know that this type of service is available? See, it's like your marketing platform, okay? But unfortunately, it is like your directory service. So you can register. You will go and register. See, this is what the web service I have created. Register in your what do you call it? It could be a Kerberos. It could be a software. Right? It could be a server software. I will go and register in there. My service. This is the web service. This web service will detect faces with very much accuracy of 99.98%. It had proven. So likewise, you could able to register the service with the clear statistics. Once your service is being being rented and people have used, and once they experience it, along with their sentimental analysis, the data what you have given will be clubbed and they will give you a corresponding feature that this service is doing this much pretty well from day one. So likewise, you will get some sort of content based a display for you, right? All those things will carry out by this UDDA. This will help us to identify the services also, right? It will store our web services. That is the primary thing. That's the primary thing. Once registered, our web service can be stored in that environment. It will give you a index page. What are all the services are stored in with us, right? They will categorize these things. We will in depth, we will study UDDA. We will in depth in study. It will have yellow pages, green pages, red pages. Likewise, it will discriminate and it will have it the registry entries, right? Emergency services will be available in the red pages, right? Emergency services will be available in the red pages. So likewise, we could have some like a directory, like yellow pages in our home, right? That will be supplied by the telephone department. We will have all these types of contents available in a book. So by visiting the index page, I could able to find out what are all the categories of services are available. That is the front page in my UDDA. Next, I could able to get into the subcategory and I could able to access a web service. For example, what are all the payment web services are available? I could able to track down and move over on that, right? So if I want to communicate towards a web service, so what does it, what made me to help me? My WSDL and SOAP will help me, right? Because SOAP will act upon my request and response services, which are being done through my WSDL. Okay. So even service to service communication or service to external communication, service to application communication, all these three communications could be monitored via this UDDI. And UDDI, the first people who have introduced the UDDI to the environment is Microsoft only. That is the reason why it's a component built in our .NET framework. Okay, it's a platform. In .NET framework, it is built in. Right? Later stages, this UDDI service, people started customizing when web services framework has been emerged, when SOA frameworks are being emerged, what happened? Instead of restricting this UDDI into a particular property services, it could be made as a open source. Right? So that made the UDDI to be available and can be customized, right? Like your, for example, you can get a RFC for your IP, you can get a RFC for your TCP. Likewise, nowadays, you can get a RFC for your UDDI, right? Request for command document is available for our UDDI, SOAP, WSDL. It is available. You can take those documents and you can create your own corresponding entities for the framework that what you are designing, right? So ultimately, SOAP is used for communication. WSDL is used for describing the web services. UDDI will help me to locate the web services. That could be the major criteria. WSDL and UDDI will be ready to serve as a procedural oriented environment to access the services, right? They will help me to access the services, right? Ultimately, the web service will be visible to the outside world only using UDDI, right? Only using UDDI. Via UDDI only, I could able to access it. So that is the criteria. And one more thing I want to talk about here is difference between web server and application server. What is the role of UDDI here? Okay, UDDI here. Because UDDI will primarily work on web service, but web service will communicate with the web server as well as application server. So how a web service is being designated for web server, how it is designated for the application server, how can I identify that, or how it will differentiate that? Okay, web server will give me my presentation environment. Application server will give me my business logic. Between these two heterogeneous environments, how my web services will behave? Okay, so that can be solved easily by this UDDI. That's also a major concern, because the interface, what it is designing to communicate with the web server, the interface, what it is designated to communicate with my application server, through that the pipelines are being identified very clearly, right? So SOAP will play a major role on that during that communication, right? So in the SOAP program, I could able to find out through the request and response messages, I could able to find out whether currently the service is communicating with my web server or application server. I have the request and response services generated by the WSDL platform, WSDL standard, will give me a clear idea whether the interface is being generated for web server or application server. I could able to find out that, because it is mandatory for me. In the next chapter, we are going to discuss about web service security, right? So in that cases, I must know, right, towards what sort of transactions are happening between whom, right? Because simply by supplying an interface, I assume that my web services are running well. I could not be able to do that. I have to monitor it. That is an important role in my quality of service, right? That what we have seen in SLA session. When you are closing layers of SOA, we have seen, right? So that could be the major thing that we need to come across, right? These three components. So WSDL, UDDI, these are the three components we are going to in-depth, we are going to cover in this chapter, right? So that could be the major idea on this. And right, see, this is an example web service platform completely designed for telecommunication environment, right? So because I from day one, I will be suggesting try to incorporate your SAA framework for your project work. I should not say in only on aspects, right? In my words, I have to show something that what you can decide further. For the purpose only, it would be helpful. People who are having knowledge or who are having flavor on networking, you can choose this. because already it's a ready-made web service platform being available. You can customize this. Okay, so it's an example for web service platform. Nothing but this could be your SOA framework, right? So access control, privileges are being managed. Session tracking is managed over there. Whenever any third-party components are being involved, that can be done through my partner management module. Charging and billing, I am having a separate software, right? Policy engine, right? I could be able to change the policies also. SLAs are available, service level agreements, right? So it is purely related with all the services actually. Traffic management and shaping, right? What about my network abstraction layer, right? Regarding complete protocol configurations are being given over on the service capability layer, right? So what are all the major services being rendered by the telecom? So that is also being given. Example, nothing but SMS, location discovery services, right? So if any sort of things are going to happen, in that case, the police officials want to track the network service only through their towers. So what are all the things that they could be able to manage? What is the push notification service? That's what even notification and presence, profile management, right? Application layer, what are all the things that is? That's what service exposure layer. Exposure means which is visible to the outside world. What are all the layers which are responsible for outside world? So through that the people could be able to communicate, right? So you could be able to see the double-headed arrow mark which are available outside the environment. You could be able to see. They have the legacy systems, could be able to communicate using a servlet API. I could be able to communicate using my application layer protocols. I could be able to communicate using WSDL or SOAP. I could be able to communicate. So the communications with the outside world is possible in any one of these options also, right? So likewise, they have customized this for corresponding field. Telecom web services. This is the, it could be like a case study, just you think of that. So people who are interested to travel further in networking related with telecom, that you could be able to have a view on this, and you can create your own and customize it, right? For example, if you want to customize it for a mobile service provider, how you will customize this, right? You could be able to customize and you can simulate and you can exhibit towards the customer, the corresponding person. For example, you can customize this for Vodafone. What would happen, right? You can customize it for BSNL. You can customize it. You can customize it and show that this model, it will reduce the burden of the environment as well as it will improve the business, means people will ready to accept, right? So that is the thing, that the reason SOA is being introduced into the environment. Right. This is a next case study. All Trust is a company, right? So they have designed their web services. What are all the web services they have? Check cashing, lending, money transfer, bill payment, prepaid, money orders, identity management, electronic deposits, government compliance. These are all the web services provided by that All Trust company, right? How clients are communicating? How their infrastructures are managed. Altrust is their company DB. External databases are there. Third party providers are there. Their entire things are purely managed with financial systems, right? Fintech. Completely they are working on fintech. So in that case, how people are communicating with the corresponding web services through their website. That's what Retail Connect. Private label, right? People who are having long services, they will come over on that. As well as apart from that, if I want to perform any type of payments and money transfers, I could use the terminals which are available in the shops, as well as I could able to go for ATM kiosks, as well as retail POS, which are completely linked with my, I think you could able to see such type of retail POS in Big Bazaars, Reliance One. So the branded supply chain stores that you could able to see over on that. So how these people are being communicated, right? This is the SOA framework via the being built over by the web services platform. That is for a specific concern, right? Specific concern. This could also we'll talk more about on this a case study, right? So what is a web service? We'll be talking always using those terms, but you must be in a position to understand that the business logic what I have developed is going to be accessed through my web service. That's all. Okay, bill payment service, I may be using AllTrust web service. That's all. What is the actual logic behind this bill payment, right? Subtracting a value, subtracting some X from a bank's account and adding that X with Y in some other bank's account. That's all. That is what the payment service is. So for that, who is supplying me the easiest way to do that? That's what the role of web service is, right? This is an interesting case study that you can concentrate for your work. This is completely based on Java, right? So I want to bring it in the module level. I found this program, this diagram will give you a clear idea what we have to see that I'm having all my ready-made functionalities, functional requirements of the projects are available as, or I could be able to convey functionalities as functional requirements as well as stakeholders who are all involving for this project. It's available in the entities.jar, right? Person, customer, category, customer order, order detail, administrator, groups, product, right? Order status. So everything is available as a complete jar file. Container, these are all my servlets, or these are all my EJB programs. So the beans are available. Next level is nothing but your interface environment, right? Interface environment. So the interface is nothing but how these logics are being communicated with the outside world, okay, via my web services. That's the major thing. So event triggering is a separate context. How these web pages and web services play a vital role. This is my store management entirely. See, Duke Store is a separate service. Duke's shipment is a separate service. Duke's payment is a separate service. Three different services are there. Okay. Three different applications are there. One company, three different applications are there. Three different applications are being communicated with one another via the web services, and it is visible to the customer as a unique one. It will be everything will be abstracted. Okay, everything will be abstracted. The communications between the module also will be abstracted for him. For him, the thing is, he will get into a website, he will order this product, he will pay for the product, he will receive the SMS for confirmation. That's all. That is the only thing. But behind the screen, what are all happening? That has been given over there, being stacked. When you are going to create your project work, it should be in this fashion. EJB container will have all my functions, right? If you have already ready-made functions, that is available as the exe file, nothing but jar file, right? That will be available over on there. So I have a main interface as a web page. Even I could be able to create some mobile application, mobile app. So how these web application and web pages, websites and mobile apps are being communicated through my web service. That's all, right? So we will see types of web services, RESTful web services, SOAP based web services, stateless and stateful. We will see in detailed fashion in the forthcoming sessions, right? I think that could be the time to close today's session. I think I have given some input for you regarding what is a web service. I think this slide is something more satisfactory for me to introduce what is a web service, what you can do already, what you know through your internet programming, you can create such type of environment. The only thing is you must know how to write the web service, right? I'll educate you. I'll advise you how to write a program. I'll show you a demonstration also that will help you. If you have already any application framework, by writing some 7 to 8 lines of code, the web service will be ready. Through that, you can communicate with the external world, right? So that's the thing.